Now take a deep breath, all right? You got the confession, then you made it inadmissible.
I mean, he's still talking.
Sucking and jiving. He knows exactly who you are.
You called me in here. You did.
I know. And if we need anything else, we'll let you know.
We appreciate the assist, Detective.
What the fuck is going on here?
We have to salvage the double murder confession is what's going on. Look, if he wasn't just running you in there, you'll get anything we get. You have my word.
Well, ease up, baby. Calm down.
I'll be back.
Well, I got it.
Tomorrow.
Stay the fuck back. I got it.
Francis, our relatives?
Yeah, sisters, a few nieces, nephews.
Connects to the suicide, how?
And I am choosing to ignore this verdict.
What? You can't ignore the verdict?
What verdict?
Chanel, your parents abandoned you. They legally disowned you 3 weeks ago and filed an amicus brief with the prosecution, stating that they think that you are a serial killer. They also want to sue you for the time that you drove your Range Rover into their living room, because you didn't want to walk all the way up the driveway? Don't worry, Miss Oberlin. You ladies are not going to prison.
Thank you.
You're going to an asylum.
What?
You know, you three are the worst human beings that I have ever encountered. You have absolutely no regard for anyone but yourselves. You're rude, entitled, narcissistic, racist, and insane. You elected to represent yourselves in a capital murder case, despite lacking even a basic understanding of the law. And then you mostly slept through your own trial. That's crazy. Your entire defense consisted of you screaming at the jury that you didn't kill anybody and then threatening to kill them if they found you guilty. That is crazy behavior. Chanel, you're crazy! Ladies, please stand. Stand up! I sentence you to life in prison at the Palmer Asylum for the Insane.
Chief, I assume a federal grand jury's coming on Danziger. I just wanted you to know, if I am subpoenaed, I am going to testify.
You assume, or you know because your FBI buddies told you?
Respectfully, Chief, get your head out of your ass.
You'd fuck yourself to fuck everybody else. I just don't understand that. You put your shit in the street? You're through, Detective. Forget New Orleans. You couldn't get a job as a B cop in bumfuck Illinois.
Fine by me.
Miss Burnett, happy Mardi Gras.
Chief Marsden, nice to see you.
Captain Rabelais?
Tony and I go way back. In fact, I'm her favorite target.
Thought I was. Purcell was a student at LSU, got expelled for threatening a professor during a disagreement. Professor filed a restraining order.
Ma'am Chapman says see on the tape before he gets killed and narrows it down to two. He also said that they were locked in the house, but how could you be locked from the inside?
We found multiple prints on the doorknob.
Yeah. I don't know. If you're locked inside of the house, Jenkins, how do you try to escape?
Try to get out through the window.
Boarded.
What about a laundry chute or something like that?
Milk chute?
What's a milk chute? Blood on the milk chute matches Brian Purcell. It's B positive, so he went through.
So maybe he goes through the chute and he's bloody. Question is, does he go through as a victim or as a killer?
Why would he go through there if he could just walk right out the front door?
He's chasing someone.
So you think Michelle went through and then Purcell followed her through?
Yeah.
We got a 20-I about a mile north of the Fort Road. Victim is seriously injured. Help! Reeves! Yeah! Reeves! Hold on, buddy! Officer down. Suspect is armed and on foot.
Establish contact.
I'm sorry, let this happen. I should never let Reeves alone.
Listen to me. Establish communication. Let him know Purcell is inside. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Then get back to that crash site. We need to find Michelle Chapman.
You might want to look at this. The reason he couldn't talk. Missing his tongue.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I'd have had these. When I was in high school, I'd have been all city.
Newest model from Nike. Mrs. Kelly, maybe you want to open that last bubble pack.
What?
What's it going to take to get you to play for Oregon next year?
Say yes.
Done deal. Full ride. Mama, you stay here. No. No. That's my son! No! Let me go! TK!
That's my son!
An infectious smile. A coach couldn't help but notice this.
I can't even imagine your pain right now. But you raised the kind of young man we all strive for.
You always get the other kind. Just when you think that he's your pal.
Say, we still $15 short.
Tennis what everybody gets.
But we had a contract, sir.
Contract? You must be one of them old country niggas. Contract.
I'll cut you every way but loose.
Hug him in the morning, kiss him every night.
Wolves came through that door?
As far as we know, we don't have a complete picture since some of our security footage was destroyed in the fire, but according to the medical examiner, whoever the smoke and fire didn't kill, the wolves did.
Do you know how many wolves were involved in the attack?
Specifically, no, but you don't have to be a scientific genius to figure a hell of a lot. May I help you?
Yeah, I need to do a level 3 once through on Evelyn Hartley's cell.
A level 3 once through? What the hell is a level 3 once through?
It's after a crime scene's been properly searched, tagged, and verified. Someone needs to just go through it one last time.
I remember you. You one of the gals from that French embassy.
Yeah, that's right.
How come you don't seem French?
Actually, I'm on loan from Interpol. I'm here to assist Miss Toussignan in whatever she may require, and today she requires a level 3 months through.
I'm sending somebody down to you, Robson. Bring it a heart this house. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Oui, oui.
That's where I parked my car.
Joining me is Lieutenant Durgan with the NOPD.
NOPD is going to do everything in its power to get the
body. Yeah, man, another unsolved case. I know what's happening. It's New Orleans. City going to hell.
Oh, come on. We love New Orleans. Who dat?
Agent Pride, I am sure as my life none of Blake's cellmates had anything to do with his death. You need to talk to someone? Max Wolf.
Which one is he?
He's none of them. Like I said, not a SEAL.
Take care of those boys.
Thank you, sir.
If you need anything, you let us know.
Appreciate it.
Should we try another theater?
In the words of James Baldwin, not upon a bigger cage, but upon no cage at all. Jim Crow must go.
Jim Crow must go. Jim Crow must go.
Hey, ladies, you can't be in here.
Yes, we can. You're going to tell us what happened here, officer.
There was a shooting. Maybe a robbery gone wrong. Son has a grievous head wound. Mother is dead. We're waiting on the coroner.